When I left college, I thought, and it was real, but now I can look back and smile on it. I really thought, I'm about to leave all these people and I'm never going to see them again. So I think I'm going to go around and say a slightly emotional goodbye. Not too emotional, but a slightly emotional goodbye. At least register the fact that I've known them. And so I went into a few rooms, and everyone's milling about ready to leave, you know. So I went into a few rooms and said, so, may not see you again, but, you know, good luck. Have a nice life. And I only had to do this about 4 times before somebody, in that very English way that I just described, where, you know, you're not allowed to be so emotional, they say, oh, I think I'm going to cry in a minute. And I immediately realized that I was perhaps being a bit radio talk show. So I shut up and didn't bother doing that anymore. I just said bye, which is always the best way, because when you leave somewhere and you say a beautiful goodbye to someone, you know that in 5 minutes' time they're going to come around the corner again. And you're going to bump into them again. And the people you really want to say goodbye to, you know they're going to drift off and you're not going to see them. That's just how life is. So, how did I get onto all that?
And then a friend says, I'm going to Los Angeles. He was posted to Los Angeles just in a job, working at university for a couple of years. And he said, do you want to come too? So I did. I had no green card, no friends, nothing really, except I knew I could stay with him for a week and a half. So I just leapt, and he got me here to New York. Loved it as soon as I got here. It was just natural. I like the illness of New York.
I was there once before for 11 months. I was just a little pawn working in the British government office. I all day long pick up the phone and say, British Consulate General. And then I was promoted to the dizzy heights of writing passports. So I wrote the names in passports, including my own actually, which sounds fishy, but it was coming up for renewal, so I did my own. And then the even dizzier heights of evaluating incoming applications for passports, according to the labyrinthine complexities of the British Nationality Acts 1948 and 1983. Because, you know, we had an empire, and it crumbled. And what happens when empires crumble is that their nationality laws become very, very painfully complicated for little pawns like me who work in the consulate.
And then coming here, and then here was just, it felt so much like home.